Dear Lord, we come to you and we lift up those who are brokenhearted because of infidelity and betrayal. There are so many that are struggling, searching for reasons why things went wrong in their relationships. Lord, for those who are wondering what happened to the person they knew, please replace the questions with peace. For those who are wondering how a person could change so much, help them to realize and accept there are just some things we will never know or understand in this life. For those who have been crushed by lies and deceit and hurtful words, I ask that you would heal the wounds and help them to find their worth in you. For those who are forced to see their loved ones move on with someone else, please comfort them, Lord, as only you can. Please, Lord, replace the longing that they have for things to be the way they used to be. May they find the courage to accept what they can't change. You are with them walking this hard road. For the times when they just hurt and they long to return to the life and love they knew, give them strength to look forward without looking back. Help them to be free. Help them to see themselves as overcomers and not just victims to this person's sin. Lord, I know they long for answers and they want to know why they weren't enough for the person they loved. Help them to see this wasn't about them or their inadequacies. It was about their mate and their problems. Sometimes there are things we could change that would have helped, but with some people, it wouldn't matter if we did absolutely everything right. It would still have ended up with the same result. Lord, please take away the feelings of failure and inadequacy. Lord, for all those who now find themselves starting over and in financial difficulties, I ask that you would provide for them. May they find a new trust in you to know that you will look after them. For those who are forced to see their children split up in visitation and custody issues, we pray for the children and we ask for your protection over them and healing for them. Please comfort the parents who must now split their time. Please comfort them when their children are forced to go when they would rather stay with them. Lord, there are so many issues that come up, so many losses at once when a family is torn apart. This is never how you intended things to be, Lord, but we live in a fallen world. Please comfort and protect those you love, Father. Oh, Lord, please comfort them all. Lord, divorce was never part of your plan. It's not something you want. But there is sin in the world and free will, and Satan lurks around trying to wreak havoc and destruction. For any marriages that are able to be restored, we ask for that restoration miracle and for you to move mountains and change hearts and bring forgiveness. Please heal memories and please restore all that the enemy has tried to destroy and take away. But for those who are dealing with their spouse whose heart is hardened towards you and towards them, we ask for deliverance. Please release them from their feelings so they can move forward with their eyes focused on you and not what was in the past, but the new road that you have before them. Lord, for those who have lost loved ones and friends in the wake of divorce, I ask that you will bring others to stand beside them to love and encourage them. For the lonely nights, I pray that you will be so real and so present. Lord, when two are joined together, you meant for them to be one, and it hurts when that unit is torn apart. But you are our healer, Lord. You are near to the brokenhearted, and you bind their wounds. You see each tear, you hear each cry, and you are able to do everything we can't, Lord. Give them courage, give them strength. Fill them with love from you, which is more fulfilling than any human's love. Help them to heal after grieving, and help them to find restoration in your loving arms. Go before them and protect them in every way, and may they feel in their hearts and minds that there is hope because of you. Bless each, Lord, I pray in Jesus' name. Amen.